Questrade. 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 Man, it just sounds so good. I think the company did a really good job finding the right name for what they do. Questrade is good. Today, I'm going to show you how to sign up and fund your Questrade account. So if you're like one of those people who is like, man, I don't have time to sign up to these brokerage accounts. Well, let me tell you something. If you have time for Netflix and chill, I'm pretty sure you can find 10 minutes to set up your own Questrade account. So make your coffee, get your computer, get comfy, and follow along with me, the setup process. But before we get started, there's a few things that I want to show you guys, the pros and the cons of using Questrade. And definitely the first pro, number one, is definitely that the fees are way lower than the fees you're gonna get with a bank brokerage account. Number two, the app is super easy to navigate. The accounts allow you to hold Canadian dollars and American dollars without additional fees. And what I love most is the super fast funding of the account. It takes about 1, maximum 2 days for the money to go from your checking account into your Questrade account. Now, on the other side, there are a few cons for using Questrade as a brokerage. First one, the transaction fees are actually not free, unlike some other apps that you can find. Also, the minimum requirement to deposit is gonna be $1,000. And also, one thing to keep in mind is there's gonna be Canadian dollar to US dollar and US dollar to Canadian dollar currency conversion rate of 2%. Now let's get started. So the first thing I want you to do is actually scroll down into the description and click on the referral link that I have down below. By clicking on that link, you're actually gonna be able to get $50 worth of free trading. And with your help, I'm gonna get a small referral bonus. So let's have you go down and find that link. So after clicking on that link, it's gonna take you down to Questrade website where you're gonna have few options to start with. You're gonna have margin account, TFSA account, RSP account, and Forex and CFDs. I personally already have the margin account and TFSA with Questrade, but I not yet have the RSP account. So that's what I'm gonna be signing up for today. For the differences between some of these accounts, I'm gonna be making a separate video later. So until then, I'm gonna be opening for myself today an RSP account, but the process is pretty much the same for whichever accounts you decide to open. So I'm gonna click add, and on the side is gonna pop up this little box with the offer code. I'm gonna click, I have read and agreed to the terms and conditions. Of course, as all of you do read the entire thing. And then I'm gonna click open now. Now it takes you to a page where you just have to confirm that you are opening one account. We're gonna click continue. And on this page, you're gonna put your first name, last name, email address that works, because you're gonna have to confirm this email address and a legitimate phone number. On the next page, you're gonna create a user ID. Come up with something simple, something you can remember, as well as a password and a confirmed password. These are pretty generic steps to a sign up process pretty much on any website. And once you're done, you're gonna click continue. And now it takes you to this page. Now, in order to continue with our process, we're gonna click on personal. Continue. In personal, you have to confirm your full name, your phone number, your email address, your date of birth, your marital status, whether you're single, married, divorced, so on. From here, we're gonna go down and you're gonna put your residential address. Once you're done, you're gonna click done. So now that the personal page is done, we're gonna go into our employment tab. Just click start. Now under the employment tab, first thing you're gonna put is you're gonna put whichever you are. You're employed, self-employed, student, or unemployed even. From after that, you're gonna have to put your employer name, type of business, job title, etc. with the address and everything. Underneath is gonna ask you three questions. Question number one pretty much asks you whether you work as a dealer or for stock exchange. If you're watching this video, the answer is probably gonna be a no. Second question is asking you whether you are a major shareholder of any public traded company. I'm not, so I'm gonna put no. And the last question here is pretty much asking you whether you are a politician. Somewhere within that range, so no. Once everything is filled in, after at the end, just click done. Now employment done, again, it brings you back to the main menu. You're gonna click on the financial. In here, they're gonna ask you your annual income, number one. Number two, liquid assets, means your stocks, bonds, ETFs, whatever that you can sell pretty quickly and you can get that money right away. So number three, that's going to be fixed assets. So in case you own a house or a car, you're going to put the amount that you own there into this little tab. And last one is going to be liabilities. So that would be maybe student debt, credit card debt, any type of debt that you owe. And at the end, you're going to find out your total net worth. Once you're done with these four tabs, you're going to click done. And then once again, it takes you to the main page. After this, we're gonna finish this. We're gonna click on citizenship. You're gonna pick which country you are citizen of. I am of Canada. Was I born in US? Not that I know. Am I a US person? Nope. And this is the most important part. This is where you're gonna have to put in your social insurance number. Underneath, you can click I confirm. They can use this SIN for ID purposes. Next question asks you if you are a tax resident of any country other than Canada or US. I am not. And the last thing is you're just gonna click that you certify all the tax residence information. Once it's complete, once you're done, you're gonna click done. And once again, you're back in the main, on the main page. Now the profile is set up, but we have to finish setting up the new account. So in this little tab, we're gonna click set up your account. Once you're in the account details, it's gonna ask you whether you want to trade options. I personally don't, so I'm gonna click no. Underneath, the purpose of this account for me is gonna be investing, retirement, and possibly personal use. And I put $1,000 as the minimum deposit that Questrade actually requires. Once I'm done, I'm gonna click done. From then on, we're gonna go into the consent and communication tab. We're gonna click start. Here you're gonna scroll down, and my advice, read through this quite carefully as you answer these questions, the way that they refer to you. From here on, at the end, just click done. And once again, it takes you to the main page. From here on, you're gonna click on persons with financial interests, start. In this page, pretty much, is gonna ask you whether you want somebody else to also have access to this account. In my case, I'm gonna say no, and then I understand and I confirm that. From here, I'm gonna click done. Once again, we're back to the main page. We're gonna click agreements and start. Now on this page, you really have two options. Either you're gonna click and open each one of these tabs and you're gonna read them all separately, or you can just trust it and click on the accept buttons for pretty much all of them. Now keep in mind that I do have a few accounts with them already set up. At the end, click done. Now you're back to the main page. Now this is great. Now we're gonna scroll down. Step number two, sign and submit your documents. We're gonna click e-sign, continue. We're gonna start by clicking I agree to use electronic records and signatures, continue. On this page, it pretty much just takes you through all the steps. Once you're done at the end, click finish. From here, we're gonna go to the second part of step number two, and it's gonna be upload government issued photo ID. You really have three options. You can either upload it directly to Questrade, you can email them the file, or you can even mail it to Questrade Inc. It's completely up to you. It's gonna have to be a photo of your driver license, citizenship card, or passport. That's gonna be up to you. And once you've uploaded the photo, they say they're gonna let you know once it's been confirmed. And the last fun step is gonna be funding your account. As you guys can see, it is 1,000 minimum required. We're gonna click fund. You have four options: pre-authorized deposits, online banking, interact online, and transfer accounts to Questrade. I personally gonna go with online banking. It takes you to the next page. This is where you actually connect your bank information to your Questrade account. You're gonna scroll down, you're gonna go into financial institution, and you're gonna find your bank. Click on it and click fund. In your bank account, you're gonna find pay bills or make a bill payment. The payee is gonna be Questrade Inc. or online brokerage. That works for me. Account number is gonna have to be the account number that you saw before in your Questrade account. Click next, and on the next page, just click finish. To actually fund the account, you're gonna have to click pay this payee. Pick from which account you wanna send. I had left $2,000 just to show you guys the process. We're gonna put an amount, we're gonna put $1,000. From then on, just the date today, and gonna click next. On the next page, just make sure to confirm all the details in the amounts you're actually sending and click finish. And that is how you fund your Questrade account. In about one or two business days, you're gonna have that money sitting in that account for you to possibly
play with.
As you guys can see, the process is super easy. It took me about 10 minutes to open this account, and it shouldn't take you any longer either. And so that's how you start with your investing journey. Make sure to click like and subscribe, because in the future videos, I'm actually gonna show you firsthand what the investing process actually gonna look like. And thank you for sticking around, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace.